Also known as The Response, the National War Memorial, situated on Wellington Street in Ottawa, was built in the year 1939 to commemorate those who have served in the Canadian military. Every year, on November 11th, the memorial acts as a gathering place for members of the Canadian government, including the Prime Minister and Governor General, veterans and current members of the Canadian Armed Forces, and the Canadian public. At first, it was to commemorate those involved during the First World War, but as time went on, the memorial began to represent many conflicts Canadians were involved in throughout Canadian history. Canada's involvement in the First and Second World Wars, the Korean War, and Canada's mission in Afghanistan are amongst the conflicts represented by the memorial. It is through these conflicts that Canadians fought for their shared values of democracy, equality, and freedom. La Grande Arche du Monument Commémoratif de Guerre du Canada est surmontée de deux figures angéliques représentant la paix et la liberté, symboliquement côte à côte. Les statues de 22 membres des forces armées qui traversent la Grande Arche représentent divers rôles dans l'effort de la guerre, notamment des fantassins, des marins, des pilotes, des infirmières et autres. Autour du monument se trouvent des plaques qui expliquent l'histoire du mémorial. Le monument est là pour rappeler aux Canadiens les sacrifices des hommes et des femmes et du Canada qui ont combattu pour la liberté dans le monde entier. Il invite les Canadiens à s'arrêter et à prendre un moment pour réfléchir et rendre hommage à ceux au Canada qui ont été tués et qui pourraient l'être dans des conflits futurs. Dans les environs du monument commémoratif de guerre se trouvent également des monuments tels que le Monument national des anciens combattants autochtones, l'hommage aux animaux de guerre, le Monument au maintien de la paix, le Monument commémoratif des vaillants et le Monument commémoratif de la guerre de 1812. In the year 2000, a new addition was placed at the National War Memorial, dedicated as the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. These unknown soldiers are those who fought for Canada and are buried across the globe. At the foot of the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, the remains of an unidentified Canadian soldier found in France can be found in the sarcophagus. This soldier fought for Canada during the First World War. Three of the four corners of the tomb are decorated with royal ciphers that represent past monarchs of Canada. The final corner is marked with a poppy. The poppy is to represent the current Canadian Armed Forces missions, such as
Месо Канада військову підготовку, хто зараз переживає військові конфлікти.
مشاركه كندا مع الامم المتحده في المجال الانساني وحفظ السلام البعثات في جميع انحاء العالم.
To me, a cenotaph is a place to recognize people and their families that have served. I'm part of a military family and I can speak from experience that when a person signs up to serve, that member's whole family and community is directly affected.
It's important to have historical monuments and statues to acknowledge our past and to educate others on our history in a society.
I think historical monuments are important in Canada because they help show how our country was developed and help people understand about our past.
So I think historical monuments are important because they provide us with a focal point, kind of a shared point of focus for individuals or groups to acknowledge the sacrifices of the past.
The War Memorial offers us the opportunity to learn and reflect. It encourages us to learn about our history, about the hardships of those that came before us, about the atrocities of our past, the likes of which most of us have never known, and God willing, none of us will ever know.
The memorial monuments across Canada leave us with a daily representation of what our country fought for and what our country represents as a whole.
Whether they are used to honor an event, take accountability for mistakes, or pay respect to lost lives, historical sites are crucial for raising awareness instead of erasing parts of our past.
National monuments are very important in our culture and in our society because they take historical events and they keep them alive. Pour les familles, qui ont perdu quelqu'un quelque part, soit dans une guerre ou dans un conflit, et ils n'ont jamais récupéré le corps, ça leur donne une place où ils peuvent aller visiter et reconnaître le sacrifice de leur enfant. So for us, it's a gesture, it's a symbol, it is something to remind us of our history, of our past, and of the sacrifices that people made to give us the freedom and the life that we have today.
The completed St. Patrick's War Memorial, located at St. Patrick's High School in Ottawa, is an example of how local communities can also reflect on the past through memorials. The display contains pictures and artifacts from those who once attended St. Pat's and served in the Second World War. The middle display is dedicated to Indigenous soldiers who also contributed to Canada's successes during the Second World War. It is also to honor that St. Patrick's High School is situated on unceded Algonquin territory. A white crucifix can be found in the display representing the 87 boys from St. Pat's who lost their lives during the war. In the display cases to the left and right are filled with photographs, artifacts, and other primary sources that belong to some of the 87 boys from St. Pat's. A list of names accompanies the display cases as well as descriptions taken from the Patrician, which was the school newspaper at the time. Dedicated to learning about who these young men were and their stories of valor became a project for three former staff members of St. Patrick's High School. Nikki Levesque and Brian Chasson, retired teachers from St. Pat's, applied for a government grant from Veterans Affairs Canada to help fund the project. They partnered up with Maureen Johnson, who had done extensive research on finding out more about the stories of those who served, interviewing veterans and families.
Our Tomb of the Unknown Soldier in Canada was created by the Royal Canadian Legion to identify and bring home a fallen soldier to represent all of those who have lost. The design, effort, and funeral of our unknown soldier connected communities from coast to coast to coast. All branches of the Canadian Armed Forces and the Canadian Government of Canada participated along with the First Nations communities. Every province and territory is represented by our unknown soldier. Together, we brought this soldier home, witnessed a national laying state on Parliament Hill. We assembled at the National War Memorial to hear our soldier's story, to stand with the friends and families torn apart by wars, to honor service. We now live out the pledge made on 28, 2000, to tell the story and never forget our unknown soldier and what is the monument means to all Canadians. To never forget our soldiers, whether they are known or unknown.
I will be sharing the words of the former Governor General, Her Excellency Adrian Clarkson, that she delivered during the funeral of the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. We cannot know him, and no honor can we give him the future that was destroyed when he was killed. Whatever life he could have led, whatever choices he could have made, are all shuttered. They are all over. We are honoring an unacceptable thing, a life stopped by doing one's duty, the end of the future, the death of dreams.
May 23rd, 2000 marks a day when the Canadian Forces aircraft journeyed over to France to collect the honorable soldier and bring them back to Canada. It was only until the 25th of May that Canada earned the responsibility over the noble unknown soldier, whose casket was brought to the Hall of Honor that evening. On the 20th day of May, the people of Canada were able to view the casket of the soldier who remains unknown and pay their respect. It was then brought to the National War Memorial, where it lies to this day.
He's an ideal. He's a symbol of sacrifice. He's a soldier in all of our wars.
The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is a soldier laid to rest in Ottawa, with its headstone held in the National War Museum. the headstone has sunlight shone down upon it on November 11, and only on this day, perfectly lighting up this piece of remembrance of our lost soldiers. The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is an important monument, which is sacred ground for Canadians. On October 22, 2014, a man armed with a rifle shot two soldiers standing guard, killing Corporal Nathan Cirillo and wounding Sergeant Kevin Vickers, who were protecting this tomb. We remember, and we always will. Every Remembrance Day, at the conclusion of the ceremony, people place their poppies on the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier.
The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier has become an important part of commemoration today. But what exactly is it? This tomb stands for all of the Canadian soldiers that have been lost in the First World War. Like any other war in history, is a truly terrible event. War, in my eyes, is the ugliest side of mankind, because it rips away the lives of many innocent people, as well as those who stand tall enough and brave enough to fight for their country. This tomb captures all the mournings and all of the grief for these people, those who were lost in war for us. It captures the grief of the mothers and the fathers who lost their child, their siblings who lost their brother or sister, their friends who grew up next to this person or even fought next to them in this war. The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is important because it has become a way of commemorating all of the grief for these people. It's important because it honors those who fought so that we can be here today and so that I can tell you about it today.
It is a frightening thing for human beings to think that we could die and no one would know to mark our grave, say where we had come from, to say where we had been born and when exactly we had died. In honoring this unknown soldier today through this funeral and this burial, we are embracing the fact of anonymity and saying that because we do not know him, we do not know what he could have become. He has become more than one body, more than one grave.
Why is the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier so important to us in Canada? This tomb symbolizes the sacrifice of all the soldiers who gave up their lives to defend and serve our country, and all the deceased soldiers who have not been found or identified. They fought so that we could live with freedom. Without their courage and perseverance, our country wouldn't be what we are today. This is why we honor the unknown soldier. We made a promise on that day at his funeral in Ottawa. By not identifying them with the technology we have, we respect the very powerful symbol they have on our country. We all know what our soldiers did, and we keep our respects towards them. No matter where we are from all across Canada, no matter our differences, we thank you all for fighting and keeping this country safe so we can live another day.
This unknown soldier was not able to live out the allotted span of his life to contribute to his country. But in giving himself totally through duty, commitment, love, and honor, he has become a part of us forever, as we are a part of him.